Greetings. This video refutes argument number 14 from the silly flood list sent by the Mohammedan. Let's look at the claim. 14. According to the Word of God, the Bible, there are birds with four legs. Leviticus 11:20. Can you name these birds? But according to Muhammad's Quran, there are animals with four legs. Quran 24:45. Consider the purpose of this argument. It is trying to imply that the Bible is stupid for stating birds have four legs, and that the Quran is superior because it correctly presents such deep scientific facts as there are four-legged animals. Well, let's first take a look at what Leviticus 11:20 actually says. King James, all fowls that creep, going upon all four, shall be an abomination unto you. That looks pretty bad for the Bible at first glance. So let's not stop with a single glance. Let's do some honest looking. The New International, all flying insects that walk on all fours are to be detestable to you. New Living Translation, you must not eat winged insects that walk along the ground. They are detestable to you. English Standard Version, all winged insects that go on all fours are detestable to you. New American Standard, all the winged insects that walk on all fours are detestable to you. God's Word Translation, every swarming winged insect that walks across the ground like a four-legged animal is disgusting to you. American Standard Version, all winged creeping things that go upon all fours are an abomination unto you. Bible in Basic English, every winged four-footed thing which goes on the earth is disgusting to you. Dewey Rheims Bible, of things that fly, whatsoever goeth upon 4 feet shall be abominable to you. Darby Bible Translation, every winged crawling thing that goeth upon all four shall be an abomination unto you. English Revised Version, all winged creeping things that go upon all four are an abomination unto you. I think you can begin to see the picture. Things with wings. Creeping things. This verse is in a section talking about dietary laws. This verse is talking insects here, eating bugs. So what did the Mohammedan do? Well, they did what they always do. They cherry-picked it. They find the one worst-sounding translation. This is sadly a very dishonest way to study the Bible. But this is very much the only way they, people in Islam, treat the Word of God. This should be a lesson for every Christian watching this. Never, ever trust what a Mohammedan says the Bible says. Look up every single quote. Getting back on point, the Quran, so wise, so scientific, so divine. It reveals the vast depths of Allah's mind. It reveals the unknowable, unimaginable, incomprehensible. Some animals have four legs. If you call yourself Muslim, I have a sincere question for you. Do you know one of the 99 names of your Allah is Al-Haq? The truth. Do you place any value in the truth? If you are not ashamed this is the way Islam is excused, you are blind, my friend. Why are people who call themselves Muslim afraid to honestly search for the truth in the Word of God? If you are an honest person, Islam is a curse on your soul, and you can feel it, but the feeling confuses you. because you think you're serving God. You really want to serve the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, but you will not find him in Islam, brother. He is calling to you, if you desire to know the truth. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.